60 major works by some of the country's most respected and much sought-after artists are scheduled to go back on the block this month. The art auction, which will be staged by the Ateneo Alumni Association for the fourth year in a row now, is designed to help raise scholarships for the Ateneo School of Humanities, while also promoting Filipino art and artists. And here to tell us more about the Ateneo Art Auction are its chairman, Dr. Leo Garcia, attorney Tony Veloso, president of the Ateneo Alumni Association, and painter-artist Al-Rajdi Muhammad. He's an emergent artist from Mindanao. Hello, boys. Welcome.
Hi.
Hi, Doc. How are you?
Yes, I'm very happy to
see
you.
Here with new art. I haven't brought home any yet. I'm sure not to bring home today because these are some heavy hitters that we have over
yes.
here. But maybe we can talk about the auction first. How did it start? It started, well, 4 years ago,
well,
right?
It started 4 years ago, and it's been progressing. It's been quite successful. In fact, last year, we were able to raise 4 million pesos in
scholarship
for the Ateneo School of Humanities.
Right.
So we're hoping that this will continue, and largely through the efforts of Dr. Leo Garcia and the Art Auction Selection Committee, that it has been quite accepted because of its credibility.
Right. And well, we were talking about it a while ago because I asked the Ateneo Alumni Association, why the School of Humanities? And you said, kasi project yan ni Doc Leo eh.
Oh.
Doc, explain why the...
It's true, but the Ateneo has 4 schools.
Mm-hmm.
But the other 3 schools, I think they can...
Are funded.
They can fend for themselves. And it's usually the humanities people that need the money. And also, it's very close to me because I was a scholar. I was one of the first scholars to go to Ateneo in the 60s,
right.
The early 60s. So we need, you know, the Ateneo is great. It's a great school because it has a good mix of about 8,000, more than 8,000 students. About 13% now are scholars.
Wow.
Yeah, it's a very big group, you know. Normally, you only have about, you should have about 1 scholar per 500 students, but in the Ateneo, 1 out of 8 or 7 even is
wow,
a scholar.
Wow, that's a big
percentage. It's a very high average. Yes.
It's a very high average. And Tony, you were saying that, of course, the Alumni Association has been around forever, but active, very dormant
well,
for
yes,
a long time. You guys started being active in...
5 years ago
when we
put up our own office and mm-hmm. We have our own staffing now. And this is one of the programs that the association established.
Would you consider
to help
this
the school.
Maybe your oldest child?
No,
or your biggest baby?
Well, it is one of our biggest programs, and it's really because of people like Doc Leo and the Art Auction Selection Committee, sina Dr. Laya, sina Attorney Bingbing Fernando, Tricky Lopa, Rico Malapas, and Rico Gonzalez, who form part of the, because of their passion, really this has become very successful.
And do you feel that it's grown a lot in the last 4 years, or do you see that it's just going at a steady pace? I mean, I feel like it's growing.
No, this year especially, because we wanted to make it a major, major auction, you know?
Fresh from Miss Universe, major, major.
It's really major, you know why? Because we really took a lot of time selecting the pieces. They're really major pieces, and for one thing, these pieces are not donated fully by the artists.
Okay.
We really select them. They do donate maybe 50%, 40%, but so they're very well chosen pieces. We're trying to do 3 things at once. We're trying to help financially disadvantaged students, but academically qualified students
yes.
to enter Ateneo. We are also trying to help emerging artists and promote Filipino art because we have to promote beauty. You know, we need beauty in this country. That's why there's so much violence. And third, we want to acknowledge our benefactors by really facilitating them to acquire good works of art. So those 3 goals in one, it was very hard to put, you know, how can you have good pieces, good works of art, scholarships, and then the...
That's a lot to tackle, isn't it?
Yeah, but I think you have to be passionate about it.
Well, let's talk about the artists. Like with, can I call you Al? Okay.
It's Al-Rajdi.
Let's point the artworks of Al. Yeah. They're so beautiful and they really are very fluid. They really talk to you, don't they? Yeah. This, the one behind Tony is yeah. one of the works of... Pero sold na ba yan? Al sold na siya.
This is a journey to the universe.
Yeah. But people have seen it before the auction. Is that why they got to already buy it? Doc, how did that happen?
Yes, this was before the auction, but we have five more bigger pieces, you know. And I'm very glad for Al because this will go to the States to a very prominent collector.
Very good.
Yeah, that's a good beginning for...
Yung sa mga project na ganito, did you do it specifically for the Ateneo Art Auction or collection mo na yan?
Bale yung mga ibang nasa auction. Bale yung mga tatlo ron intended for auction.
Para sa auction talaga. And ganito rin yung aesthetic niya?
Oo, halos ganyan din yung proseso ng paggawa.
So what is your process? Ano ba yung proseso mo dyan? Parang mukha siyang... Hindi ko alam. Hindi naman siya mukhang oil. Parang acrylic, pero hindi. How did you do that work of art?
Halos yung ginamit ko dyan, halos ink at saka lacquer.
Lacquer? Tapos inaapoy mo raw, sabi mo, di ba?
Bali may mga ganong proseso ako sa painting na sinusunog ko sa... ganun. Pero yan, yung ganyan, pinapatakbo ko siya sa tubig.
Yeah. But it's very creative.
It's very creative. And your artists, what are the sort of genres that you have? Is it an eclectic mix or?
It's both from the master. So we have a very beautiful set of four paintings by H.R. Campo.
This is what you see in front,
1974,
right?
1974, from a very prominent collector. So we have from the masters, the established artists, mm-hmm. Mostly abstract also, because many people, we still need to promote abstract art because most people like representational art, figurative art, and of course the emerging artists.
Right.
So people can look at the website, ateneoartauction.com.
Before the actual auction,
yeah,
so they can start bidding na.
Yes, they can start bidding. And because in fact, we've received already some bids. Yeah.
And Doc, for the last 4 years, you've also had paintings of masters, right? Because
yes.
That's exactly the point. You want to merge sort of the new artists and the masters. For this one is H.R. Ocampo, yes?
Yes.
And let's say, what would the starting bid be for something like this? And it's four paintings.
Yeah,
it's a little scary that we even have it here beside
yes,
us in the, it's, in the studio.
Yes, these are priceless paintings because HR is already a national artist.
Yes.
And this is very important because it shows the transition of HR Ocampo from figurative to abstract. And they are in his favorite colors, green, reds, oranges. And they were really commissioned by this prominent collector. So they have been with him since 1974.
And this collector gave it willingly? Is it consigned?
Consigned,
what is
and he, of course, he will donate a portion to the art auction. So it's a come on for people who love the arts to come here. We have also Olmedos, the two Olmedos
yeah,
there
they're
are
beautiful.
Very beautiful.
Wow, they speak to you really,
yeah,
don't they?
The blind singer and the solitary lady there.
And even though it's in black and white, there's still so much of a story.
The medium is ink wash. Yeah, parang. And we have, of course, Leonard Paras, who has made waves in international auctions. So, I go almost to all the art openings just to find out who are the artists that need to be, the young artists who need to be promoted. So it's really a very big investment on time.
For sure. And you're an art collector yourself, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
So are you ready for this?
No.
Are you going to make a bid for it?
No, this is beyond my budget. I think...
But Tony, who do you see in these auctions? Do you see the usual suspects? Or, well, obviously the ones who are ready and willing to collect a lot of the master's works. But do you see newbies who want to get into art? Who do you find is your clientele for the art auction?
Well, it's a good mix, but we already have our regular clientele, part of our mailing list. But there are new ones. Yeah. There are new ones who, you know, become interested and show particular interest in some of the arts that are art pieces that are being displayed at our auction.
Yeah, they're not only Ateneo collectors, but you know we've gotten I think the really avid collectors. So I think it's a good mix, no?
Yes.
Right. Yeah.
And for, let's say, the emerging artists, just so that people have a clue, because maybe someone is listening and they want to sort of go there and maybe buy their first work of art,
yes,
or auction for it. How much are the pieces that are more from the emerging artists? Because these ones are a little untouchable.
Yeah. From the emerging artists, we have pieces that are that begin with 20,000 pesos.
Okay, that's really quite reasonable, yes, actually.
These ones, I guess they would go for 80,000.
Okay. Di ka na ma-reach, ha? But how is your experience? Natutuwa ka ba na you're part of this whole... Syempre, you're also helping people go to school sa humanities, di ba?
Natutuwa po. Sa nagpapasalamat po sa nakasama sa Art Talks.
And yeah, these works are going all the way to the States, too.
Yes. You know, when you believe in an artist, you have to promote the artist. You know, that's like... Even from my collection, sometimes if I believe in an artist, I would send one to Christie's in Hong Kong, because you have to promote the artists. I think.
And you're well connected, Doc. So people who want to be known the world over, super well connected. Yeah. But okay, so maybe we can tell them, because the auction is ongoing online now, obviously. So people are already bidding for it. So maybe you can tell us, Tony, the process of how to do it, where to go, and then when exactly the auction day itself is.
Well, we have the website, which is the Ateneo Art Auction, and they can already bid online. But the event itself will be on October 1. That's 4 p.m. at the Finale Art Gallery along Pasong Tamo.
Okay.
2241 Pasong
Tamo.
Okay. And Doc, you were saying that last year you guys gained 4 million? Is that correct?
Yes.
Net profits. Yeah. Actually, even more. But we gave 4 million to the school of humanities.
Okay, so Doc, just invite everyone to gun for more. You have to go for more than 4 million this year.
Yes. I would like to invite the generous people. If you want really great art, come to the Ateneo Art Auction on October 1 at Finale Art File, La Fuerza Compound, 2241 Pasong Tamo, Makati. And there are preview days on September 29 and 30 from 10 a.m. to 7 p.m.
Okay.
Yeah.
Doc Leo, Al, and Attorney, thank you very much for being
you
here.
Thank
all
you
the best.
For having us.
Thank you, Lexi.
To the Ateneo Art
You've
Auction.
You've been of great help to us.
So good.